Scott, to you, Sue. You know, you've certainly lost an important member of your family, and she was an important member of ours, too. She really, really was. And we'll do whatever we can to help you. As we begin, we remember that it was in the waters of baptism that Anna died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with Christ eternal glory. On the day that she was baptized, Anne put on Christ, signified by this white pall. In the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed with glory. As a follower of Jesus Christ, Anne certainly knew her share of the cross of Christ. May this crucifix remind us of Christ's victory over death. Brothers and sisters, as we gather to mourn Anne's loss and pray for her, we celebrate the very central mystery of our faith, the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, made present here as we remember it. So if you would please pick up one of the worship aids now, turn it to page 3, and we raise our voices as we sing together, "How Great Thou Art."
Thank you.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Anna, also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond her pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and makes cloth with skillful hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor, and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive, and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward of her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord. Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we also await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will change our lowly body to conform with his glorified body by the power that enables him also to bring all things into subjection to himself. The word of the Lord. Gospel according to John.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Throughout the scriptures, one of the most enduring images for the love of God comes from human shepherds. Just as human shepherds guard and protect and guide and watch over their flock, Israel was convinced that God, the Good Shepherd, guides, guards, watchovers, and protects Israel. In fact, that's exactly what we prayed in the Psalm, Psalm 23, expression that that's God's consistent love. And God always expected the leaders of the people to imitate, to be good shepherds, but they hardly ever followed his example. They were too busy shepherding themselves. And so the prophet Ezekiel says to his people after they've been taken into Babylon, "This happened to you because your shepherds were too busy taking care of themselves instead of you. But God," Ezekiel says, "will send, will shepherd his flock." And of course, we believe that that's fulfilled in Jesus. Yesterday was Good Shepherd Sunday. And not only did we hear from Jesus who says, I am the Good Shepherd, just as he says today in this reading, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So Jesus is the Good Shepherd. And that's one of the images, that's one of the themes throughout the Gospel of John. So the first descriptive title given to Jesus at the very beginning of the Gospel was when John the Baptist says, look, behold, there's the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And at the end of the Gospel of John, Caiaphas says to the other members of the priestly formation, he says, you know what? You know, we need to sacrifice this one for the sake of the nation. And his statement became more true than he ever thought. Because on the day of preparation, as Caiaphas, the high priest, was preparing his lamb for the Passover celebration, the real Lamb of God, was being sacrificed on a mountain, on a cross. Jesus laid down his life for us. And that wasn't the end. He was raised from the dead. And the Good Shepherd, raised from the dead, has become the Lamb of God, as we see on the front of the altar. The Lamb of God who feeds us and nourishes us. You know as well as I that Anne believed that very, very much. You know, as long as she could, she would come to Mass every Sunday. You know, they'd always go out that door, you know, and she and Bob would yell at me because he couldn't hear anything. And you know, you knew they had that deep and abiding faith. And not only that, but she really did her best to be a shepherd herself. You know, that's what good leaders do. That's what good parents do. You know, that's what good servants do. They are willing to lay down their lives for their flock. And Scott and Sue, you can tell them how often and how consistently she did that for you. And I think that's very, very important to remember that and to talk about it. And then the Lord invited you in the last couple of years to reverse that role, where you became the shepherd for her and for Bob. And so we reinforce our faith in the Good Shepherd. In fact, that's why the Good Shepherd's up there. That image is so important to us, that willingness of the Good Shepherd to lay down his life. And do you know what we're praying for today? You know, we're all those sheep that are being drawn to the Good Shepherd. You know, he loves every one of us. He knows and calls us by name. He wants us to be with him. And what we're praying for today is that there's Anne, you know, seated on his lap. And of course, we continue to pray for her. As good as she wasn't perfect. You know that. You know, we commend her to the Lord's mercy for the way she may have failed and say, Lord, she's one of your lambs. She's one of your flock. Please take her home. You know, and in the kingdom, you know, in the kingdom where life is transformed, you know, Bob can hear and her mind is back. That's what we're praying for. That's really what we're praying for. And when Jesus says at the Last Supper to the apostles, don't let your hearts be troubled because I am the way, the truth, and the life, our hearts need not be troubled precisely because of our faith. We deepen our faith today in that mystery. We believe this isn't the end for her. But our hearts are troubled. It's never easy. It doesn't make any difference how old a person is, how ready that person may have been to go to meet the Lord. It's never easy. And so don't be afraid to grieve. Don't be afraid to ask for help in your grieving. Because in pouring out your pain, you're allowing the Lord to pour in his consolation, his love. So Anne, we praise and thank God for the gift of your long life. We praise and thank God for your willingness to be a good shepherd. And we pray more than anything else that you're sitting in that lap. My brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. And to each of these prayers, please respond with the words, Lord, hear our prayer.
For Anne, who in baptism received the light of Christ, scatter the darkness and lead her over the waters of death to your eternal light. We pray to the Lord. For Anne's family, who seek comfort and consolation, especially her children Scott and Sue, and her nieces and nephews, heal them in their pain and console them in their grief. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died in the Fearing and Ivan Kovig families, especially her husband Robert, her parents Paul and Anna, her brothers Albert and Paul, and her nephew Jim, grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. For a greater appreciation of the beauty of creation, may we see the power of Christ's resurrection in the springtime renewal of the earth. We pray to the Lord. For students, especially those who study theology, may their minds and hearts be transformed by Christ, the wisdom of God. We pray to the Lord. For those of us assembled here to worship in faith, may we be gathered together again in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord. For those intentions which we hold in the silence of our own hearts,
Father of mercies and God of all consolation, you pursue us with untiring love and dispel the shadow of death with the bright dawn of life. Comfort your family in their loss and sorrow. Be our refuge and our strength, O Lord, and lift us from the depths of grief into the peace and light of your presence. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Enable us, therefore, to press on toward him, so that after our earthly course is run, he may reunite us with those we love when every tear will be wiped away. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Together we sing from the worship aid on page 5, Here I Am, Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Anne, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the unending hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Please kneel, but be seated if that's not your custom. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord. Let the voice of resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Pius X, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope and Kevin our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Anne Faring, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in this resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, 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 amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Please kneel, but if that's not your custom, you may be seated. We're now invited to come forward and be fed by the body and blood of Jesus Christ. So please come down the center aisle singing the Lord's praises, and you can receive the Lord's body under the form of bread. And then as you go back to your pew by your side aisle, you can drink from the chalice, the precious blood. If you're not in full communion with the Catholic Church, we invite you to come forward for a blessing. And to signal that you like a blessing, just cross your arms like this. And then I have low gluten hosts if you need one. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
And he will.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Anne, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. At the end of Mass, if all of you would just please follow us down the aisle. We'll go through the courtyard and then out to the hearse, and then Anne's body will be taken for cremation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Anne. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And now we sing a song of farewell, and you'll find this song on page 10. And as we sing this song of farewell, we honor her body with incense, because that body was a temple of the Holy Spirit. And as the smoke of the incense goes to the skies, we're convinced that our prayers for her go to God. Page 10 in the worship aid. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Anne, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed upon her in her life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and Anne, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You're attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness, through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.